Do you want early access? Do you want uncut reactions? If so, then check out our Patreon. Link in the description down below. Well, as to what happened last time, our boy Otto stepped up, and we also found out about his very, very sad backstory, about the fact that he can communicate with animals and insects, and not only that, but he was ostracized because of a big, like, misunderstanding, and also the fact that, you know, corruption, everybody. Subaru basically just kept saying, "I love you," to Amelia, until eventually she was just like, okay. It's not how it works in real life, but okay, I guess. I don't know. I mean, it's an anime, so I'll give it a pass. So, all that being said, though, with everything going on, as soon as it was all said and done, they leave the temple, and there's Gar, just literally standing there, just being like, "I'm going to kill you." He's like, "Oh, I know, and I'm gonna give you, like, all the reasons why that'd be a bad idea." And, yeah, basically...
Which could also mean that Otto and Ram are potentially dead now. So.
Potentially. But this episode, I don't... No one can lift a Quaine stone alone.
I don't know what a Quaine stone is.
All I'm going to say is team lifting? I mean, it's always recommended. Even though I don't follow that protocol sometimes. I'm a dumb. I can't help myself. I see something that needs to be lifted, and I'm just like, "I got this." Ow, my back! Anyway, so yeah. ReZero, starting life in another world. Episode 41. Let's get into it. Let me get this up on screen, and let's check it out. Gar? I'm sorry, the fact that you lost out on your mom and, you know, your half-sister left and everything, doesn't mean you need to condemn everyone else to the same life that you're living. The drowning man will always take someone down with him.
いや。怖がってるじゃない。アピール。うん。お前は自分を置き去りにした。母親のことを恨んでるのか?えた母親と母親を奪っていった外の世界が憎いから。お前は正義を閉じたままにしたいのか?このことを言ってみろよ!母さんに幸せになって幸せになるのに邪魔だったんだろ!幸せになるために外に出てったんだ!
What he's saying right now does not math with the pictures of her face and her expressions and the flashbacks of her.
No, it doesn't.
She didn't look at all like she couldn't bear to look at them. She looked like she loved them.
Like something bad happened with his mom, her leaving and everything, and he blamed himself and basically invented the narrative in his head that, of course she wanted to be away from me. I was baggage.
It could easily be a situation where, like, she needed to leave in order to find help to get them out of there.
Yeah.
And obviously, with the way this world is, she may not have made it very far.
Probably not.
There you go.
Oh, man.
Oh, no. That seal his power? He ain't as strong as he used to be, because his power is uppercut.
Okay.
He did it. Holy shit. Oh my god. He has the He's a beast, man. What do you expect? Amelia. Ouch. Oh.
No suplexing me this time.
Yeah. Sleep well, Garcia.
Subaru passing out's not good, though.
No, it isn't.
He's on retirement. Taida no majo inshi.
Otto! Why?
Because you did something crazy.
What?
通訳いりますか?
心配させないでよ。でも今は邪魔しない方がいいと思うの。ああ。ちょっと。ならとっとと解きなさい。いい加減足がしびれたわ。もっと工夫しなさい。だければもっと工夫しなさい。負け猫ガーフ。 She extended out the perfect because of like, damn it.
ガーフが変われるのか、それともうずくまったまま動けない小さな子供のままなのか。まあ大丈夫よ、ガーフ。泣くほど怖い目にあったら。
See, he was just a baby. How can he remember what happened when his mom left?
どうしても行くんじゃな。ふーちゃんとお母ちゃんに。お母ちゃん、お母さん、行ってくるわね。
あなたのお父さんを連れて戻るから、それまで待っていてね。私のこともガーフのことも愛してくれていましたわ。家族のためにお母様は聖域を出た。どうしたいんですの？求められてることをして。 思い出させてくれたからだ。母さんが俺を愛してくれてたことは。
Acceptance. Thank God. can stop running away from that pain and move on in life.
それでシーマさんは、
ああいや、その辺ややこしいからまた今度で。心配かけて悪かった。
ああ。
クゲリアつけてきたつもりで。
Good。
ああ試練に納得できたのは多分てめえのおかげだ。ありがとうよ。
Holy hell。
お前今お礼言った。
Yeah,
you
know what
I'm saying. いいか。でうまくやれや。大将。
すごく赤い顔してた。
大将って、俺たちのてっぺんはエミリアタンなんだ。
年上なんだから、多めに見なさい。
まあそれなら。
Fair enough。
って待て。今あいつが俺より年下みたいなこと言った。
ガーフは今年でようやく14よ。
Oh my god。
12じゃねえか。
The world's most jacked 8th grader ever. Jesus.
Yeah, you got criminy. Murdered by an 8th grader like twice and almost a third time.
だからほら、さっきの。その大事なことだから。試練と他のたくさんのことが片付いてからゆっくりお話しね。
行ってらっしゃい。
You got
this. 車と男に気をつけてね。
She's like, what the hell's a car?
で分かると納得だ。俺も偉人の格言とか引用してた時期があったし。あのよ、大将にちっとばかし謝んなきゃいけねえことがあったよ。
What's that?
見ちまって。お？大将がそのなんだ、ひしこいた結果を。
あ、
しまった。これだけ負けた相手が大将でよかったってな。うるせえ、忘れる
バカ。
僕も応援してる。これが済んだらデートしようぜ。
Wait, is that what he?
When did he have time to write all that stuff?
When he left her? When,
really?
Yeah, when she promised, or when he promised her he would stay with her. That's why he wasn't there.
It's not a very good reason.
Well,
exactly, nincompoop.
Yeah.
捨てるのよ。絶対の絶対。謝るまで許してあげないんだから。客番来だね。
あ
れだけ集体を晒してよくもまあおめおめと顔を出せたものだね。さしもの僕も踊ったらどうだい。魔女の娘。
Wow. I was right on the previous episode.
Yeah. 私の名前はただのエミリア。エリオール大神。同じ魔女の悪意になんて屈してあげない。私、面倒くさい女だもの。
Okay.
I wish she had pointed at her and been like, and you're just a dead old bitch.
Or just like, get fucked, echidna. Just, yeah. Just something. That'd been funny as hell. So yeah. Dude. What a freaking crazy ass episode. That was great. That was a great, great episode.
It's probably the best one of the season. So far.
I would say so too. Because you had Garfield's revelation. Like, in his acceptance of his past, which, as someone who just, like, recently put my past behind me, I appreciate that so much.
It really tells you how much I think they missed the mark with the previous episode, with the whole, like, I love you, and the kiss and stuff.
Yeah.
Because you could tell they were trying to make you feel something with that.
Yeah.
And they dropped the ball on that for me. But this episode made me feel something, like, for Garfield.
Oh,
like,
dude.
I did not expect that at all, either.
Well, it's because Gar, like, is obviously holding on to a pain that he doesn't completely understand. And the fact that he was able to, like, just open up after realizing the mistake of, like, of thinking that his mother left for selfish reasons and he blamed himself for why she tried to leave. Once again, that's just, it's not healthy to blame yourself. Especially when you don't know the truth. And now that he knows the truth, and now that he knows that his mother tried to leave to go find their father, like, that completely changes everything for him. And the acceptance of that basically means that he doesn't have to be angry anymore. He doesn't have to be who he has been, and instead he can literally just move forward. He can literally move forward as a character, and he's not just the angry dude who just kills everybody when everything starts going wrong. Instead, now he's someone who is on their side and basically is understanding, like, I've been angry at myself for so long, and I've been holding the sanctuary back from being liberated for so long, it's time to let this end. And thankfully, it seems that that's what's going to be happening. And then, of course...
So hopefully, if anybody was pissed off at me in the previous episode for being, like, meh about their kiss and everything, and you're just like, this guy doesn't have a heart, he doesn't feel everything. Hopefully, this episode changes your mind, because obviously, I felt something.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'll call it out, too. I mean, being all gushy and everything with the kiss and everything, just being like, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Just saying it until Amelia is just like, ah, all right, just kiss me. Mwah. There you go. Whereas in
it's
this
not
one,
exactly how it went.
Well, I know. I know.
It was not the best written thing, in my opinion.
No. But, like I was saying, the whole deal is just like, it wasn't the best, but this definitely made up for it. Because, yeah. Also, finding out why Subaru left in the middle of the night and broke his promise to Amelia. I mean, that to me doesn't completely absolve him of what he did.
It kind of irks me more than anything.
Yeah, but...
Like, I know they meant it to be like, oh, he was just being sweet. And like, dude, it would have been sweeter to not break your promise.
Exactly.
It's like,
that's... And plus, here's the thing. He wrote all that shit on the wall and drew Puck over and over and over again. Instead, he could have kept his promise, stayed there with her, and then he could have gone back later, and then he could have drawn the shit on the walls, like, just, like, where it mattered most, like, around the doorway. Like, around the next doorway. That would have been the perfect place for it, because then she would have walked in there, and as she was walking towards the door, she would have been like, wait, Puck? Is this from Subaru? Aw, you idiot. And, you know, could have had that sweet moment, and also could have kept his promise.
I don't think she would have said you idiot at that point, because he kept his promise. Like, that's the only reason she was calling him an idiot. She was calling him an idiot because he broke his promise to go do that.
True.
It's like one of those things, it's like, oh, this is sweet, though, so I'll give it a pass, and it's just like...
Nah.
It would have been a lot sweeter to just keep your promise and stay with her, dude.
Exactly. Because
that's not the play, in my opinion.
Because if you would have done that, you wouldn't have had to pull the whole I love you thing to her over and over and over again, and then eventually just, like, wear her down to where she just accepts it. Instead, she would have known that you love her by you staying with her and keeping your promise. It's like, when you keep a promise to someone, when you make a promise to someone, you keep it. I mean, I think that's one of the most integral things. And I know sometimes shit happens, and, you know, sometimes it's impossible to keep your promises, but you should do everything within your power to keep them. At least that's how I feel about it. Anyway, yeah, so nobody can lift a queen stone alone. Yeah, I mean, Gar's right. And now that everyone's working together, I actually have faith that this crazy-ass plan's going to work. I mean, we'll see. I don't know. But I think that's going to do it. So until next time, I'm Nate.
I am Nick.
Y'all be good people. Be safe. Peace.